What is sensorineural hearing loss? Well, in this video, I'm going to teach you what it is and what your treatment options are. Coming up. Hi guys, Cliff Olson, Doctor of Audiology and Founder of Applied Hearing Solutions in Anthem, Arizona. And on this channel, I cover a bunch of hearing-related information to help make you a better informed consumer. So if you're into that, consider hitting the subscribe button. Now, there are only three types of hearing loss, but the most common one is sensorineural, and it's often abbreviated SNHL. But what happens when you have sensorineural hearing loss, and what do you do about it? Well, let's jump right in. First, you have to understand how we hear. Now, the hearing system can be broken down into three distinct sections: the outer ear, the middle ear, and the inner ear. The outer ear consists of your auricle, your ear canal, all the way down to your eardrum. The middle ear consists of that eardrum through the ossicles, or the bones of hearing, and also your eustachian tube and middle ear space. The inner ear encompasses the cochlea, which is also called your hearing organ. A sensorineural hearing loss occurs when there's damage to either the cochlea or the structures inside of the cochlea, or the auditory nerve that goes from the cochlea up to your brain. Now, some common causes can be either head trauma, ototoxic chemical exposure, a tumor on your auditory nerve, other genetic factors that you might have, or noise exposure, and most commonly, age-related hearing loss. A typical hearing test can easily identify if you have a sensorineural hearing loss as opposed to a conductive hearing loss or a mixed hearing loss. Earlier, I mentioned several causes of sensorineural hearing loss, but the most common causes are noise exposure and age. And when you have noise-exposed hearing loss or age-related hearing loss, typically what happens is that the outer hair cells in the high-frequency range end up dying. What this causes is this lack of perceived clarity when people are talking to you. And that's because high frequencies encompass clarity in speech, and low frequencies encompass volume in speech. So this is typical for someone who has an age-related hearing loss or a noise exposure-related hearing loss to come in and say, well, I feel like I can hear fine, but people are just mumbling, or I just can't understand what they're saying. Another common complaint that I hear when someone has a noise exposure-related hearing loss or age-related hearing loss is that when they go into a noisy background, that noise just overshadows everything. And that's because if you have good low-frequency hearing still, you'll have a phenomenon that's called the upward spread of masking, which means you hear the background noise really good, but it drowns out all of those high-frequency components and takes away all of your clarity, so you really can't understand speech in those situations. So now that you know what causes sensorineural hearing loss, how do you treat it? Well, treatment will depend on where the damage occurs, either in the cochlea or along that auditory nerve. So, if you have outer hair cell death inside of the cochlea, the outer hair cells are your ear's natural amplifier. So when sound comes in through your ear, those outer hair cells make that basilar membrane vibrate more, which sends a more powerful signal up to your brain. But when those outer hair cells die, your ear cannot naturally amplify sound, so it requires the use of a hearing aid. Now, it's important to understand that a hearing aid only works in this situation when the hearing aid is fit and programmed properly using real ear verification. Now, if you have excessive inner hair cell death, a hearing aid isn't going to provide you a massive amount of benefit. Hearing aids are only really good when it comes to outer hair cells. So when inner hair cells end up dying beyond a rate of which a hearing aid can help, then you start becoming a candidate for a cochlear implant. And what happens with the cochlear implant is that you bypass the cochlea entirely and you stimulate the auditory nerve electrically. Now, if you have an acoustic neuroma, which means a tumor growing on your auditory nerve, you could potentially get benefit from hearing aids if that tumor is small and isn't growing, but if that tumor has to be removed, you'll be left with no hearing on the side that you had the tumor on. When that happens, you become a candidate for either a CROS device, which sends sound from your bad ear, or that ear that no longer hears, and reroutes it over to your better ear, so your better ear can use the sound from that side of your head. The other option is using a bone-anchored hearing device that is actually implanted on the back of your skull, vibrates your skull, and helps your ear on the opposite side hear. In some extreme cases where both auditory nerves have tumors and they both have to be removed, you actually could potentially be a candidate for an auditory brainstem implant, which, just like the name suggests, is an implant right on your brainstem, which will then trigger your brain to hear. Over 90% of hearing losses are sensorineural in nature. and a large portion of those require hearing aids as the main treatment option. That being said, it's impossible to know exactly which treatment option is right for you unless you have your hearing evaluated properly by an audiologist. If you feel like you're experiencing hearing loss, your best option is to schedule an appointment with an audiologist so they can find out exactly what type of hearing loss you have. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you liked the video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more videos just like this one, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. I'll see you next time. We'll be right back.